I went to Bali for the first time in the summer of 07 with Surfing the Nations, and it changed my life. I'll never forget how I felt on my last day there, just knowing that God was calling me back and that Bali was leaving a mark on my heart. I met Ado and Claire that year. They ran Elevate, the Bali Community Youth Center, in Bali's southern Bukit Peninsula. As soon as I got home, I emailed them and asked them if I could come back and volunteer with them the following year. As I waited, I studied Indonesian and finished my senior year of high school. In June of 08 until August, I went back. It was such an amazing trip and such a cool organization to be a part of. The youth center has an indoor skate park and they have a surf team for the kids, but also reach out into the community in so many different ways. The coolest thing was to see how they're raising up Balinese leaders to spread the message of Christ within their community so that the people there are hearing about God's love for them from someone just like them. I was truly touched. I love to see how the center used Balinese traditions to worship God. And I can really say that some of my best friends in the whole world live in Bali. I love it there. And I'll never forget the things that God spoke to me there. I continued to pray about being full-time there because that was really what my heart was. And I was just waiting for God to give me a sign of what my next step was. I will just never forget going to my first ceremony in Bali. It was a funeral ceremony, and I was just praying while all the Balinese were praying. I was praying to God just about my future, and I just kind of like was crying out to the Lord. Like, I had such a peace about being there, and my heart was there, and I just said, God, I want to be here full time, and you know, I just want to give this up to you. And I felt like within the next couple weeks, I just felt God kind of confirming that I will be in Bali again and that the Balinese people will be a part of my life for a while. And I'm not sure what he means because he's God and he always seems to switch things up. But I began to pray about when that was going to be, and I felt like I really heard him say that I needed 2 years before I could be full-time. And so I was kind of bummed, but I just began to pray, like, God, where do you want me to go? You know, what do you want me to do? And I really felt like he said, in the faintest whisper, you already know, Michaela, you already know. And at that minute, I just knew that he was talking about Surfing the Nations. Surfing the Nations is such an awesome ministry. They're based out of Hawaii, and they use surfing on mission trips all over the world as a tool to spread the message of Christ. They focus on the 1040 window, which is the most unreached people groups in the world. And they do trips all year, but then they also have a student leadership program where you go and live in community with others for 3 months. You have reading material, you wake up in the morning and have prayer and lectures. And they also have a huge feeding program within Hawaii, which is a big problem there. And so I'm gonna go in January and start the leadership program there. And then after I graduate, just continue to pray about my future and what's next for me. Can't you see that?